Everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples. Rooting section number one has its money on Bobby Van and Elaine Joyce. Rooting section number two backs Jerry Stiller and Ann Mira. Rooting section number three is betting on Dick Gautier and Barbara Stewart as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Tattletales. We have an uproarious group here today. We have quite a good group up here, too. As you know, our studio audience is divided into three sections, each one rooting for one of our celebrity couples. And every time one of our stars up here wins some money, it is divided among their rooting section. Now, as I said, we have three celebrity couples. They're all crazy as loons, and you'll find that out in a minute. Let's meet half of them, shall we? Here they are back here, the husbands. Hello, gang.
Here we are, the loons.
Here they are, the loons.
Crazy loons.
See no evil, hear no evil, and speak no evil. Goodbye. We'll see you in just a minute. We don't want you to hear what we're doing out here. Goodbye, fellas. Don't forget to write. And now to the ladies. And they're not crazy as loons. They're as sweet as they can be. How are you? Lovely.
Oh, who's fine? You
nice
look so handsome.
Thank you. You're not so bad yourself.
Thank you.
Okay. Handsome. We'll be back with our first round of Tattletales right after this message. Don't go away. We're coming right back.
Shop online at Chewy.com.
Okay, we're back ready to play our first round of Tattletales. The ladies are out here with me, and the fellas should be all right. But how are the boys in the back room doing?
Hi.
We're doing okay.
You're doing okay, huh?
The music is great, and we're waiting.
Yeah. Okay, we're going to come back to you in a minute. Sit tight, fellas. See you
Bye.
In a minute. Okay, ladies, I'm going to ask you some questions about your husbands and your lives together. I want you to think it over, and when you think you have an answer that your husband will recognize, sound that signal in front of you. Now, you have to do it quickly because we will only take one response, okay?
Okay.
Here is the voice question. It happened on a vacation. Elaine first.
Was she first?
Okay. Oh. Elaine, tell us all about it.
Well, we were on a vacation, and it was in Puerto Rico,
mm-hmm.
and we rented a car. We always rent a car wherever we go. First mistake. We rent this car. It breaks down. Bobby says, why don't you get out and push it? My luck, I couldn't drive stick shift. So I get out, and I push the car. And you know how it is in Puerto Rico? All of a sudden, it'll rain, just like that. The sun's out over here, and it's pouring over here. I'm behind the car, pushing the car, and a cloud absolutely dumps on me. The rain just, bam, like this. I couldn't believe it. I walked around the window, and I looked at Bobby, and I said, look at me, I'm soaking wet with rain. And no place else on the street. It hadn't rained anywhere else. Just right on my head and on my glasses and everything. And then the people came out of the buildings and were yelling, witch, witch. I couldn't believe it. And I swear to you, this is a true story. It was unbelievable. And that's our vacation.
Okay, that's a good vacation story. What we need from you now is a one-word clue worth $100 for your rooting section, or a two-word clue worth $50. Which one do you think Bobby will recognize?
Not which. I need a clue, and I can't say
it can be a two-word clue or a one-word clue. No, you can't use Puerto Rico. No.
I'd say... wait a minute, I can't think. You're making me nervous. Say Puerto Rico, so I'll have to say,
it happened on a vacation, and your clue is
okay. Car.
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 All right, she's gonna go for a one-word clue. Okay.
Yes.
All right, let's bring on the fellas. Okay, fellas, we have asked the ladies a question. What I want you to do is to sound that signal in front of you when you recognize your wife and think you can match her answer from the clue. Here is the question. It happened on a vacation, and the clue is car. Okay, Bobby. You're on, Bobby.
Go,
tell
baby.
Us about it.
Oh, yeah. We were in Puerto Rico. We rented a car. And I asked Elaine to push it.
That's right. That's what she said. We'll score $100 for that. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Okay, fellas. We'll come back to you in just a moment. All right, ladies. Ready for the next question, are you?
Yeah.
Here's the next question. Same question. It happened on vacation. Okay, Barbara, tell us all about it.
Oh, good, I got it. Oh, I'm so nervous.
This is it?
Yes, this is it. Well, we were in Paris, France. And
I didn't think Texas.
Well, no. But anyway, we were in Paris in a hotel, and I had been learning French, but I get the days of the week mixed up a lot. Well, Dick had not taken any clothes over because he was going to buy them all in Paris,
right.
But nothing fit him because he's too heavy. But don't tell him I said that. So he had nothing but one pair of pants that he wore all the time. So when we were in the hotel, he said, "Look, I've got to get these pants cleaned. We can't go out tomorrow night." I said, "Okay, I'll give them to the chambermaid." Well, when the chambermaid came in, I didn't know Judy from Vendredi, and I didn't say bring them right back. I had said bring them back in 2 days. He spent the entire weekend in the hotel.
Without his pants on.
And I was out running around.
Okay, let's... What we need is a clue, then. We need a one-word clue worth $100 or a two-word clue.
Pants.
All right. Okay. Let's bring on the fellas. Okay, fellas, we've asked a question. We have an answer. See if you can recognize your wife's answer from this clue. The question is the same question as before. It happened on vacation. And the clue is pants.
How well I know.
Tell us about it, Richard.
Well, she was studying French and not doing too well, I might add. And we were in Paris on a trip, and I had brought very few clothes with me, hoping to buy a lot of clothes there. Unfortunately, nothing fit me. Everything was like, 37, 38 shoulders.
You were too fat.
Shoulders. Oh, I see. That's it. So
I have these big butch shoulders,
But a little tiny slim waist. So what happened was she told the chambermaid the wrong day. She said Saint-Maldé instead of Vendée, one of the French words, and I was stuck on the
moment. That's what she said for the $100. You're smart. Very nice. Okay, at this point, Ann and Jerry have yet to score, but I know they will. Elaine and Bobby have $100 for their section, and Barb and Dick have $100. Close game. Very close game. Now we're going to do what we call a tattletale quickie. Fellas, I'm going to ask you a question, but don't give me the answer. Just think about it, and then we'll get back to you.
Okay.
Here it is. Good question. Men?
Yes?
For $10,000, would you pose nude for the centerfold of Playgirl magazine? Think that one over. $10,000, fellas. Would you bear it all? We'll be back to you in just a moment. Good one. Okay, Barbara, what do you think about Dick? Would he let it all hang out for Playgirl? What'd I say? Can I say something? I didn't say anything.
Let it all hang out, sweetheart.
What do you think?
Man, he better. I'll tell you, I'd let him pose in New York City right in Manhattan nude for $10,000.
Now, wait a minute now. Do you think he would?
Yeah, I think he would.
You think he'll say yes? Okay,
let's you better.
Okay. Okay, Dick.
Yeah.
Try to keep a straight face, Dick.
I'll try to calm down.
All right, Dick. For $10,000, would you pose nude for Playgirl magazine?
I'll strip right now for $5,000. Yeah, sure I would.
Yes. The answer is yes. Thank you, Dick. Okay. Okay, how about Jerry Ann? Would he pose nude for $10,000?
I feel if he could place his hands where he wanted to.
I don't have that on my card, though, unfortunately.
I think he'd say yes.
You think he'd say yes?
Yes.
Okay, let's see what he does say. Jerry.
You talking to me?
Yes, I am, sir. Can you hear me now?
I can hear you clear, yes.
Then here comes a question. For $10,000, would you pose nude for Playgirl magazine?
The answer is no.
Would you consider 15?
I thought you would. It doesn't say you could have done that.
It's only because we have a wine commercial, and I don't want to conflict with that.
Oh, wine has no conflict with nudity.
No, they don't want a picture of your feet. They want the whole body.
I would not. I know. I have two children at home, and I just don't want them.
Such
all right,
a Jewish
thank you, Jerry.
Saint.
Goodbye. you can work on him later, Anne. He'll change his mind, maybe. If it ever comes up.
I'm going home in a separate cab.
All right, Lane, how about Bobby? Would he pose nude for 10 grand?
Bert, I have so many conflicts. In the first place, he was asked. But they didn't say $10,000. They just said, would you? And he said, no, because like Jerry, he has a Kodak commercial going. And so he said, no. But now $10,000, no. This is a game.
Makes it a little different, right? True.
So, for $10,000,
now they're making me nervous again.
I'm supposed to figure it out. I live with him.
Would he pose nude for $10,000?
No. No.
Yes.
Okay. That's your answer. Okay, let's bring him on. Bobby, you know the question.
Yeah.
Would you pose nude for 10 grand for Playgirl?
Well, I'll tell you the truth. They asked me to do it, and I turned them down, so I'd say no. I don't care what they said. I still say no.
He said no. I'm sorry. No score there.
I don't do anything for money. I do it for love.
That means it's halftime, and halftime finds us with Ann and Jerry still yet to score. Elaine and Bobby have $100. Barb and Dick have $200. Close game. Okay, we're going to play turnabout now. Ladies to the rear. Gentlemen, front and center. And while we're changing places, we'll break away, but we'll be right back with more of Tattletales. Don't go away. We'll be right back. Come on out, fellas.
Facial hair is a problem.
Okay, we are back. As you know, our studio audience is sharing in the winnings of our celebrities up here. But let me tell you this. If your rooting section is backing our winningest couple today, we will add a bonus of $1,000. Okay? Honk-a-dunkle. Gentlemen, here you are, front and center. It's your turn to sit out here. Let's see if the ladies are situated all right back there. Ladies, how you doing?
Okay.
Okay, you got your music and everything?
Yeah.
Huh? All right, we're going to get back to you in a moment. Don't go away.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
Okay. Okay, fellas, as you know, I'm going to ask you questions about your wives and your lives together. If you have an answer you think your wife will recognize, tap that button in front of you, but try to be first because I'll only take the first one, okay? Here we go. First question. A time company dropped in unexpectedly. Wow. That was fast, Richard.
Well, all I heard was company. Before you said unexpectedly, I did. Well, what happened was I was, for Screen Gems, they wanted me to do a Western. And I don't rarely wear clothes around the house because, you know, we have some kind of privacy. And I had these twin guns strapped on, and I was naked, and I had on a cowboy hat because I was practicing a fast draw. You got the picture?
I got the picture.
So,
you got the picture.
And I was wandering around the house doing this. Barbara was in the other room doing something. And in walked our good friend, Ruta Lee, in the back door. Yoo-hoo! And she walked in and she saw me. Dude, it's true.
Oh, boy.
The clue should be
you tell
guns.
Me. The clue should be guns, huh?
Guns.
I think you'll recognize that, don't you? Okay, let's bring on the ladies.
Hi.
Hi, ladies. We've asked the fellas a question out here. I don't believe the answer, but... Okay, we've asked the fellas a question now. When you think you recognize your husband and can answer the question from his clue, sound your signal. Here is the question. Not the clue, just the question. A time company dropped in unexpectedly... And the clue is guns. Barbara, you're right. But I'll tell you something. I want to hear that story again.
I told you my husband is a nudist. I swear the man was testing. He was going to test for a Western. And he walked around the apartment all day with two guns at his side, stark naked.
That's what he said.
Embarrassing word.
We'll come back to you in just a moment. Bye now. Next question, if you don't mind. Okay. Here's a good question, fellas. Your wife with money. Okay, Jerry. Good place, Jerry. Tell us about your wife with money.
Great guilt about spending anything that she earns. No matter what, even though she earns it, she'll come back and tell me, and is it all right for me to have bought this dress? Of course, that means that she's going to be very nice to me.
What a terrific problem to have.
All right. My wife.
I don't have that problem. Do you guys?
All right. That's it.
That's it.
Yeah.
She has... So how would you give a clue for that, Jeff?
Guilt. Guilt is
guilt,
a good
huh? Right. Okay. Let's bring on the ladies and see what they say. Ladies, we've asked the fellas a question. Get ready. If you can respond when you hear the clue. Here's the question. Your wife with money. And the clue is... guilt. All right, Ann, tell us the story there, if you will.
Well, I tend to overtip, and he doesn't.
That's
cheap.
The smallest.
What?
That's the smallest part of it all.
No, I tend to give. I think if you. Well, it sounds very pretend that if you give something, it'll come back to you, but maybe from another direction. And, like, you know, even when I was at unemployment insurance, I took cabs. I lived on SpaghettiOs.
Let me see.
What did you buy for?
What?
No, you see, now the thing is, you came in right, but the story does have to match, and I'm
well,
sorry.
Well, I spend money all the time. I like to buy, you know, I
no,
buy...
No, tell her what you said, Jerry, exactly.
Well, when you do buy things,
yes.
like dresses or whatever it is, you become very anxiety-ridden about it, and you tend to be very hesitant about telling me these things.
He said guilt, you know,
guilt.
You had guilt.
I just say that to you. That's all.
Well, I'm sorry, darling.
Not
we
really
can't match
guilty.
A story.
No,
I'm learning
point,
a few things about
Ann
money.
And Jerry have still yet to score. They will. Elaine and Bobby have $100. Barbara and Dick are leading with $300. And we'll come back in just a minute. More time again. Hang on.
Join AARP today, and you get this travel bag and AARP the magazine free. Call 1-800-731-2341. That's 1-800-731-2341. Or go to getaarp.org.
All right, we're back. This time we're going to play a round of Tattletale Quickies. Ladies, I'm going to ask you the question. Don't give me the answer now. Just think about it. Here it is. This is a good one. Ladies, can a woman be in love with two men at the same time? Ooh, that's a good question. Think about it. We'll come back to you in just a moment. That's also a dangerous question, isn't it? All right, Dick. tell us about it.
Can I skip this one, Bert?
Yeah, I tell you, I think that Barbara would say that, yes, you can love two men at the same time in a different way, you know, is the qualification, but still, there are men that she loves in a different way, I hope, than me. And because she has a lot of very dear male friends, she keeps telling me, until 7 o'clock in the morning. No, seriously, that's it. I really believe that she says
okay,
yes.
Okay, Barbara will say yes, you say, for $100. Let's bring Barbara in and see. Barbara! Good question, huh? I can see the perplexity on your face.
Oh, boy.
What do you think, dear? Could a woman be in love with two men at the same time?
I am going to get murdered, but I think yes.
That's right.
You did?
Yes.
He knows me.
The look in the face. Really?
Oh, my gosh. Oh.
I know you, you kid. You've done it now, Barbara. You better take off.
You better stay in that little green box.
Thank you, Barbara. Okay, Jerry, how about Ann? Do you think Ann will think that a woman can be in love with two men at the same time?
Yes, as a matter of fact, we've discussed this, and she she said, Jerry, you understand that when I'm playing a role with somebody else, like she did Love is Another Stranger with Harry Gardino, that I'm allowed to fall a little bit in love with my leading man. Is that okay, a little bit in love? And I had to go along with it because I thought that if she would come back to me after she met all these wonderful people, it would be a great mitzvah for me to have given her to the world.
So you'll say yes.
Yes, right, right.
All right, let's bring on Annie. Annie, what do you think? Can a woman be in love with two men at the same time?
I hope we're on the same wavelength, dear. I think so.
That's what he said. $100. Thank you, Annie. Okay, Bobby, how about Elaine? Will she think that a woman can be in love with two men at the same time?
First of all, I think these two guys are in a lot of trouble. And, no, I would say the way my wife defines the word love, I would say no. One man. One.
Okay, let's find out what Elaine says. Elaine?
Yes?
Can a woman be in love with two men at the same time?
No.
Ah, that's what he said for $100.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Confidence. That's confidence.
Okay, you are absolutely right. Oh, wait a minute. There's the end of the ball game. That means our winners today are Dick and Barbara Gaudier. Okay. Barbara and Dick, you won $400. We're going to add $1,000 to that for a total of $1,400. Okay, we'll be back. Just a moment. Don't go away. We'll be back with more Tattletales.
Come today.
Trust me, your skin will thank you.
Okay, we're back. We have everybody out here with us. Congratulations to Barb and Dick. Now, Ann and Jerry and, and Elaine and Bobby, your ruling sections get $100 and $200, too. That's not bad. Oh, Bobby, you've got something coming up. Why don't you tell us about it?
Well, yeah, quickly, I'm going to be opening at the Riviera Hotel in Las Vegas. So if anybody's there at the time, come and see
me. Get there, try and see
May 22nd.
Okay, that's all the time we have. We'll see you next time on Tattletales when our celebrities will be sharing their secrets and their winnings with a studio audience. Bert Convy saying so long.
This is Jack Clark speaking for Tattletales, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.